Please,
don't hang up. I don't have any more change. I'm soaked to the bone, Miss McFadden, and I have a very low threshold for disease. Look, I don't know what Tony told you, but he's got my money, and I got a lease, and you got the apartment. Now, one of us got screwed. Let me rephrase that. We have to talk this out, and I am in no condition, financial or health-wise, to look for a hotel in the pouring rain, you know? I mean, if there's any such thing as the 78th Street flu, I think I've got it.
Why don't you take a shot in a convenient place?
5 minutes! That's all I'm asking! What is it? Now look, in about 30 seconds, we're gonna get cut off. Mr. McFadden, my number is 873-5261. It's a flooded booth on Amsterdam Avenue. If you have any compassion in your heart whatsoever, I'm trying to work it out, operator! Any compassion in your heart whatsoever, you'll call me back. 873-5261. That number again is 873-5261. Oh! Hello, thank you.
5 minutes. Leave your bags. This isn't a permanent conversation.
Dripping on your rug.
It's been dripped on before.
Look, I'm sorry about this. I didn't know that there were going to be any complications.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of that going around lately.
I don't blame you for being hostile. I think I get the picture. Tony rented me the apartment and split with the money, right? And then you and your daughter got dumped on?
That is your version. My version is that Tony and I amicably end our relationship. We agreed I would keep the apartment, and you and your $600 got dumped on. Get the picture?
Very sharp. Sharp. That's very sharp. You a sharp New York girl, right?
No, a dull Cincinnati kid. But you get dumped on enough, you start to develop an edge.
Okay. So what's the deal, huh? I mean, I got a lease here in my pocket. You gonna honor it or what?
I got a daughter in my bed. That tops a lease in your pocket.
Look, I don't want to get legal, you know? Legal happens to be on my side. Now, I happen to have a lawyer acquaintance downtown. Now, all I gotta do is call this lawyer acquaintance of mine.
Oh,
whoa, whoa, what?
An actor. Another goddamn actor. I happen to have a lawyer acquaintance. Right out A Streetcar Named Desire. Stanley Kowalski in summer stock, right?
Wrong. Chicago in the Dead of Winter. 3.5 months at the Drury Lane Theater.
Ask an actor a question, he gives you his credits.
You want to hear the reviews? Elliot Garfield brings to Kowalski dimensions that even Brando had not investigated.
Terrific! You write beautifully. Aren't you a little short to play Stanley?
Nobody noticed I stood on the poker table. What are you, a critic?
No, no, I love actors. As long as they stay up on the stage where they belong. But you put them down in real life and the whole world gets screwed up. Well, I have had enough. I am not getting kicked out of the same lousy apartment twice. You want your money back? Go to Naples. You want this apartment? You buy me 2 tickets to California. I will give you 2 minutes to think it over before I yell rape.
Jesus, you are really something, you know that? Really? I'm surprised Tony didn't take a job in the Philippines.
I hope you're thinking because I am counting.
Will you wait a second? Just hold it. Will you just hold it? Can we make a deal?
What kind of deal?
I don't know. I just got here. Can I have a cup of coffee?
No.
Oh, don't be bashful. Just say what's on your mind. Okay. All right. Here is the situation.
I know the situation.
Just let me say it out loud, all right? I mean, I don't really believe this myself. Number one, I have a job off Broadway, but I have no place to sleep tonight. Number two, you don't have any money, but you've got my apartment.
Also, you have a daughter to think about.
I am thinking of her right now.
Do me the courtesy of hearing me out, please. You are not the only one who can scream rape, you know? We are both in a bind, the two of us. And I think the only practical solution is that we share the apartment.
I accept.
What?
I accept. I may be stubborn, but I'm not stupid.
You mean it?
I have a daughter who goes to school, and I have to start looking for a job. You have a key. I would have to stand guard all day long to keep you out. I accept. You win. Get your bags. You get the small bedroom.
What the hell am I getting myself into, huh?